Shawn Mendes, always amazing. Welcome back to another daily video, sis. Huh. What are you wearing? What are you doing? I know we're just step siblings, but let's save that for later. Let's just get started with the video first. So on this channel, I've talked a lot about auto-tuned singers, and often when I see live singing, I can be a little bit like skeptical because they often use backing tracks and stuff. So what's exciting about this video is that we're going to be listening to famous singers slaying without microphones. They're going to be slaying, absolutely murdering someone without a microphone. I don't know why you would need a microphone to murder someone, but that's where we are. Let's get started.
What flavor is that?
What a surprise. Ariana Grande can sing in real life. I would never have thought that. I thought she was the worst singer in popular music right now. Kidding. Of course she can sing. She's always not warmed up here. I was surprised by a little miss in the falsetto there, because I've always seen her be so pitch perfect all the time. Way better than I am. But I mean, even amazing singers are not warmed up a lot of the time. I would say a lot of the time in my videos when I'm doing these commentary videos, and then I'm like, oh, let's try to sing that. Then it's like I've been sitting here like for like 10 minutes or whatever, and it doesn't sound good. It's very different from when you warmed up. So she's obviously like getting her makeup done here, and she might warm up later. Maybe she's trying to do a combination of warming up and getting her makeup done. Very smart, very time efficient. That's what you do when you're a busy boy, like Ariana Grande. Next. Man, those are some pretty harsh frequencies, actually, now that I heard it in Ariana's voice. I mean, this is amazing, obviously. It's super controlled, and it's like the same piercing frequencies all the time, but they're like, such a wonky outfit with the ears and everything. It feels like they're trying to cater to some kind of thing that many old men like with the materials and stuff. I don't know. Anyway, next. We should have had it
to the beat.
It's cool. I can see Ariana's like star quality here as well. I think she was already on TV and stuff by this, but she was uploading this as like a YouTube video, I think. And you know, it's not only that she's a great singer, but it's also like, obviously she's a very attractive girl when she sings as well. That's something that's very different from me, for example, where like when I sing, I look like I'm about to have a big poo-poo while she looks like good. And then you have people like John Mayer that look like idiots when they sing, and it works anyway. Let's watch the next singer. Man, that's dope. Mariah Carey is like also so amazing. I think Ariana really looked up to Mariah Carey, and that's kind of like how she got started with the whistling singing and stuff.
We are lamely.
Wait, is that how I did it? Mm-hmm.
We are lamely. I got all my ladies with me.
Oh, her like airy falsetto thing, it's so good. When Mariah is on form, she's amazing.
Yeah.
Nice runs. Man, her whistle registry actually sounds good. There's something about it that like doesn't sound that much like a tea kettle. Well, it does, but it sounds like a very nice sounding tea kettle. That was a very pleasant tea kettle. Beyonce, let's see. What you got, Beyonce? Can you sing in real life? I don't think so, Beyonce. Beyonce is an amazing singer because like she definitely has a lot of registry and she can sing high notes and whatever, but she focuses a lot more on like really nice sounding registries and like really nice tone, and I really like that. I think she's amazing. However, did you guys know that Halo was actually written by Ryan Tedder of One Republic? It's pretty crazy. There's like a demo online of him singing Halo, and it's really dope.
Ooh, what's this YouTube channel? RoomieOfficial. Looks like a cool guy. Looks like he should maybe hit 6 million subscribers soon.
Maybe I'll reveal my real singing voice without microphone at 6 million subscribers. Not even maybe. At 6 million subscribers, I'll reveal my real singing voice without a mic. Without a mic is a weird expression, actually, like what they're talking about in this video, because obviously there's a microphone recording if you can hear it on video. But let's see. Ryan Tedder, Halo. I ain't ever gonna shut you up. I mean, it sounds amazing in the demo. I think Beyonce did a lot with it, though, with the way she sang it and stuff. But man, Ryan Tedder, what a bomb songwriter. I just gotta talk about this because it's important. So you guys keep pointing out when my nipples show in my golden shirt that I use for some of my videos. Check this out right here. Good little nipple down here in his shirt as well. I'm just saying, good singers and nipples in shirt. There's a correlation. Come on. Good nipples means good voice. Let's get back to the singers. That's good, some solid belting. I've never been a huge fan of Lady Gaga's voice, but I think it's good. She sounds a little bit too theatrical or like musical-esque for me in most of her stuff, but she's definitely a good singer. We all have our tastes, okay? Let me know in the comments if I suck at having tastes. It sounded good, but I'm just like, why is she like in the mall singing her own song? Like, is she holding, is this like a Gucci bag? I'm just confused about the scenario. Sounded really good though, very good. I think she's got good tone. And do ya, do you think about me? Shawn Mendes, always amazing. I mean, he pretty much blew up from this type of thing. Like stuff where you see that it's like a live take on Vine or whatever, and he's amazing. And I mean, he's a good looking dude, amazing singer. Of course he was gonna get picked up. Well, I mean, not of course. There's a lot of people who do that who still don't get it, but he deserved it. He's amazing. He's still slaying it. Oh yeah, and as I always say when Shawn Mendes comes up, look at this video where I wrote the song with Shawn Mendes that I filmed like 4 years ago or whatever. It's a great one. I actually have footage from that video where he says, subscribe to RoomieOfficial. Let's see if I can find it. I don't think I'll find it. I think I threw it away. Because I'm an idiot and I didn't know how massive he was gonna become. It would be great to just have that in every video. Shawn Mendes come in and be like, oh yeah, subscribe to RoomieOfficial. He's the best. Anyway, next. Okay, you're not allowed to say anything bad about BTS. I feel like that singer can sing a lot better than that, but it was fine. Man, I'm really scared of BTS stans. I really am. I would never say anything bad about them. Not even... Oh, well, I would. I'm not okay, but that was fine. When 난 아직도 너를 포기 못해 난 시들어진 추억을 붙잡고. Okay, I'm not gonna say anything about BTS. I'm just gonna slowly move on from that. I'm sure it was great. I don't know Korean. Maybe, you know, the pronunciation was amazing. Probably. Let's keep going. Little Mix. Black magic. Okay, so I was really shocked at first because it sounded really bad. And then I realized that it was like whoever's filming it was singing like tone deafly with them. But then all their ad-libs and stuff were amazing. They can really sing for sure. Yeah, it sounded really freaking good. Man, isn't that awesome? Because everyone was talking about how pop artists, like, I don't know, like 5-10 years ago, like were talentless or whatever. Oh, they can't do anything. And nowadays, at least when it comes to, you know, more singing stuff. I mean, I can't say anything about rappers because rappers rely so heavy on autotune. But I truly believe that the level is way higher now than it used to be. But then I also think that there's a level where, like, if someone's too good at singing, it's almost like unlikable. That might actually be in the way of people that are like really, really amazing, because I think like if someone's just mind-blowingly good at singing, it's almost like something that puts a distance between the performer and the listener. It's like threatening in a way when someone's that talented. It's almost like there's a limit to how talented you're allowed to be before people will not like you anymore. Deep talks with Rumi. Let's continue.
Don't let go. They sound good. They sound like they all have Beyonce as an idol. I feel like there's four people trying to be Beyonce here. Maybe I'm totally wrong. Let me know in the comments if I'm totally wrong. I don't know a lot about Little Mix. Little Mix cite Beyonce, Michael Jackson, Destiny's Child, and Vogue and Rihanna as their musical influences. I was right. Roomie was right. I'm not always right, but today I was right. Give me the clout. Let's keep listening. I didn't hear her at all. I just heard a tuba. If Demi Lovato was doing that tuba sound, that's really impressive. But I only heard I mean, there were a couple notes that you could kind of hear, but not enough to know if she was slaying without a microphone or not. I'm not sure she was slaying, guys. She might just have been like slightly stabbing and not slaying totally. Oh my god, I love LMI or LMA. I forget how it's pronounced. Anyway, I've seen these videos before. I think I went on her Instagram in one of my videos. Amazing. I love it. It's so good singing. I'm always blown away listening to her. Big love hearts on the ice from me. Next. Ooh, Christina Aguilera.
You told me how proud you were when I walked away. If only I knew what I know today. Okay.
So that was like an impromptu, like, I'm gonna sing a cappella in the studio. It sounded great though.
What a girl wants, what a girl needs, whatever keeps me in your arms, and I'm thanking you for being there for me. Yeah.
Oh, that was nice. I love that little run. She was great. She is great. Is it only me or does Christina Aguilera look different? She looks super different here from what she did in this clip. I don't know if it's just like a weight thing or something else or just an age thing, but I feel like she looks totally different whenever like she changes her makeup or whatever. Maybe she's had work done. I don't know. Just something to think about. Taylor Swift. This is gonna be interesting. That was cute. It was fine. That song seems really hard to sing. It's like, we are never, ever, ever getting back together. It's just like a bit of an awkward thing to sing. Next. I mean, that seemed like a little bit of a weird thing to take as an example of someone singing without a microphone. They seem to just be jamming, which is like when you kind of like exploring new melodies and stuff, while the other people have been kind of singing songs they've been rehearsing and stuff, and you know, their own songs. So it's not exactly the same. Justin sounded great though. He always sounds great. I think he's a really talented singer. Sorry if I looked like I just didn't like it there. I thought the singing was great, but I just wasn't sure that was Miley Cyrus. I don't believe that's Miley Cyrus. It looks like it's just someone else. Oh, okay. It's her friend and Miley's behind the camera singing and she's lip syncing. That makes a lot more sense. It's Miley singing, but there's someone else on the camera. This is so confusing. That was super fun. That's a really funny video. And the singing was pretty stellar. That was some great belting. Miley's a great belter. I always like the sound of it. She's got another one of those voices that has like really nice tone to me. I like it. Click here for videos of me singing. Click here for a playlist of my greatest hits videos. And I will see you tomorrow in the next daily video. It was fun to see some famous singers sing without microphones. Most of them sounded really amazing. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.